Today I'm going to discuss about calculation of sag is when the supports are at unequal level. In the hilly area, the transmission line conductors are suspended between supports are at unequal level. And supports are at equal level, the two supporting structures are at same level. But when supports are at unequal level, one supporting structure in the lower side, another supporting structure in the higher side. Here, the supporting structure is represented for what supporting structure one is represent for A, that is lower side of the conductor, lowest point, and highest supporting structure is represent for the B. The sag means the difference of the two supporting structure and the lowest point of the conductor is called as sag. Here, the difference of the two supporting structure, that is supporting structure B and then supporting structure A, and the lowest point of the conductor is represent for O. Lowest point is represent for O. Here, we don't know how much is the span length, one supporting structure to another supporting structure. The supporting structure is represent for pole or towers. The pole, we are used for distribution purpose. For towers, we are used for the transmission line. For 66 kV, 132 kV, 220, 400 and 765 kV, the supporting structure we are used for towers. For three phase, 440 volt and 11 kV, 33 kV, we are used for the poles, that is used for RCC pole, reinforced cement concrete pole. Here we don't know one supporting structure to another supporting structure, the span length. That's why we are taken for L is represent for the span length. It is represented in terms of meter or kilometer. The L is represent for the span length, that is either 200 meter or 250 meter, 300 meter, so on, etc. And the X1, that is the total span length we are represent for the L. And in this, the lowest point of the conductor, this is represent for the O. From supporting structure A2, in this the particular point to O, the distance is represent for X1. That is the distance of supported lower level, that is supporting structure A from the point O. And X2 is represent the distance of the higher level. This is for the lower level, this is for the higher level. Distance of the support at higher level, that is the B, supporting structure B from the point O. And T is represent tension in the conductor. H means difference in level between two supports. This is the highest H is represent for the difference in level between two supports. This is for the supporting structure A. Beyond how much, this is for the height, that is H, the difference in level between two supports, that is support B and then A. And W is represent for weight per unit length of conductor, weight per unit length of conductor. Here, this represent for the sag, that is the lowest side is represent for the sag one, and the highest side is represent for the sag two. The lowest side is represent for the sag S1 and highest side is represent for the sag S2. When supports are at the same level, we are getting only one sag, that is S equal to W into X square by 2T. Already the last class we have discussed, that is W into X square by 2T. But here the two supporting structure, one is for the lowest side of the conductor, another one is for the highest side of the conductor. The lowest side of the conductor we are represent for sag S1. Highest side of the conductor we are represent for S2. But we know that what is the sag for individual? S equal to W into X square by 2T. Here two sag is there. One is for the S1, another one is for the S2. That is S1 equal to W into, what is the distance? The supporting structure A2, that is the lowest point of the conductor, the O, X1. That is W into X1 square by 2t, W into X1 square by 2t. And what about the sag 2, W into X2 square by 2t. Here, the supporting structure B and the lowest point of the conductor O, the distance is represent for X2, that is W into X2 square by 2t. Now here, in this, the diagram clearly represents the total span length is X1 plus X2 equal to N. That is from the figure clearly represented, X1 plus X2 equal to L. Now, Already we know that the difference of the sac, that is highest minus lowest, that is S2 minus S1 equal to H. That is S2 minus S1 equal to S2 minus S1 is represent for the this height of the, how much the difference of the two level support, that is H equal to highest minus lowest, that is S2 minus S1 equal to H. Now you can derive, that is S2 minus S1. S2 in the sense the sag at the highest side of the conductor, S1 in the sense lowest side of the conductor. What is S2? That is W into X2 square by 2T, W into X2 square by 2T. What is S1? Minus this one, W into X1 square by 2T, W into X1 square by 2T. Here, the both the term W by 2T is common. You should take common W by 2T. That is W by 2T, if we are taking common, we are getting X2 square minus X1 square. X2 square minus X1 square. That is S2 minus S1 equal to W by 2T into X2 square minus X1 square. It is in the form of A square minus B square. Already we know that, that is A plus B into A minus B. It is in the form of S square minus B square, that we can write down A plus B into A minus B. Now we can split in this equation, that is W by 2T into, it is in the form of A square minus B square, that is A plus B into A minus B. X2 plus X1 into X2 minus X1. But already we know that the figure clearly represented the total span length is X1 plus X2. What is X1 plus X2? L. That is W into L by 2T into X2 minus X1. S2 minus S1 equal to W L by 2T into X2 minus X1. This, when the supports are at an equal level in the hilly area, the transmission line conductors are suspended between supports at an equal level. One is for the lowest side of the conductor, another one is for the highest side of the conductor. That is, here the supporting structure we are represented. The lowest side of the conductor is represented for the supporting structure A, and highest side of the conductor supporting structure is represented for B. And the span length from one conductor to another conductor, we don't know how many meter or how many kilometer. That's why we are taken for the span length is L. The span length is L. And the S1 in the sense, the sag of the lowest side of the conductor. And the S2 in the sense, the sag of the highest side of the supporting structure. And the H in the sense, the difference in level between two supports. That is support B and then support A. B minus A is represented for the H, that is S2 minus S1. And the X1 we are taken, the distance of the support, of the supporting support A to the lowest point of the conductor O, and X2 is represent for the distance of the support at higher level, that is B from the lowest point of the conductor O. And T in the sense tension in the conductor, W is weight per unit length of conductor. Already we know that when the supports are at the same level, the sag we have derived S equal to W into L square by 2T, W into L square by 2T. But here the two span is there. One is for the lowest side of the supporting structure, another one is for the highest side of the supporting structure. Now what about the sag S1? W into here from supporting structure A to the point O, the span length is X1. That is W into X1 square by 2T. And what about the highest side of the conductor, the point O2, the supporting B, X2, that is W into X2 square by 2T. In this figure clearly represented, the total span length L equal to X1 plus X2. Now, that is, we want to find out the H, that is S2 minus S1 equal to H, that is S2 minus S1. What is the S2 value? W into X2 square by 2T minus W into X1 square by 2T. In this two term, W by 2T is common. W by 2t is common. You should take common this x2 minus x1 square. That is s2 minus s1 equal to w by 2t into x2 square minus x1 square. It is in the form of a square minus b square. That is a plus b into a minus b. That is x2 plus x1 into x2 minus x1. That is already we know that. What is the x1 plus x2 total span length? L. That is w into l by 2t x2 minus x1. Now, we want to find out the two sac. One is for the s1, another one is for the s2. Now, already we know that what is s2 minus s1? That is total h. That is h equal to, already we have find out, what is wl by 2t into x2 minus x1. This is h equal to wl by 2t into x2 minus x1. This is the cross multiplication. Note on what is the x2 minus x1 value? X2 minus x1. By cross multiplication, that is 2th by wl. Now, here we want to find out the x1 and then x2. That is the sag s1 equal to w into x1 square by 2t, x1 square by 2t, and s2 equal to w into x2 square by 2t. Here we want to find out the two variables. One is for the x1, another one is for the x2. Now, already we know that in this the figure, what is the span length? That is equation 1. Solving equation 1 and then equation 2, we are getting the value. What is the equation 1? That is the equation 1 is x1 plus x2 equal to L. X1 plus x2 equal to L. What is equation 2? That is minus x1 plus x2 equal to 2th by wl. 2th by wl. Now solve this equation. This is gets cancelled. 2x2 equal to 2x2 equal to l plus 2th by 2th by wl. But for us required only for the x2 value. That is x2 equal to, this 2 goes to the dividing. That is l by 2 plus numerator and denominator 2 gets cancelled. Th by wl. Th by wl. Now we are getting the value of x2. Similarly, we want to find out the x1 value. Now, in this, the equation 1, we can substitute. That is, what is the x1? That is, x1. What is the value of x2? Plus l by 2 plus th by wl. Th by wl equal to l. That is, already we know that x1 plus x2 equal to l. Substitute in this equation the x2 value, we are getting x1. Now, what is the x1? That is, x1 equal to, that is l, this goes to the right hand side, minus l by 2 minus th by wl. Th by wl. That is, x1 equal to 1 minus half, that is half. That is, x1 equal to l minus l by 2, that is plus l by 2 minus th by wl. This is the value of x1 and then x2. Now we get the value of sag s1 and then sag s2. That is, substitute the value. This what happened? S1 equal to w into x1 square by 2t. What is the value of x1? L by 2. L by 2 minus th by wl whole square. Whole square by 2t. This is the sag 1. What is the sag 2? W into x2 whole square. What is the x2? L by 2 plus th by wl. Th by wl whole square by 2t. This is the sag at the highest side of the conductor, and this is the sag at the lowest side of the conductor, lowest side of the conductor. Now here, that is S2 minus S1 equal to H. Already we have derived. What is the S2 minus S1? WL by 2T into X2 minus X1. By cross multiplication, that is X2 minus X1 equal to 2TH by WL. Here already we know that the two sag is there. One is for the lowest side of the conductor, another one is for the highest side of the, one is for lowest side of the supporting structure, another one is for highest side of the supporting structure. That is, we know that S1 equal to W into X1 square by 2T, S2 equal to W into X2 square by 2T. Here we want to find out the two parameter. One is for the X1, another one is for the X2. That is, the simplify equation 1 and then 2. What is equation 1? X1 plus X2 equal to L. What is equation 2? Minus X1 plus X2 equal to 2TH by WL. Now, solving this equation, plus minus gets cancelled. 2X2 equal to L plus 2TH by WL. What is X2 value? This 2 is divided. That is L by 2 plus 2THWL by 2. That is numerator and denominator 2 gets cancelled. Finally, we are getting that is X2 equal to L by 2 plus TH by WL. And similarly, we want to find out the X1. That is substitute X2 value in this equation 1. That is X1. What is the X2 value? Plus L by 2 plus TH by WL equal to L. Here we want to find out X1. That is L, go to the right hand side, minus L by 2 minus TH by WL. That is 1 minus half, that is plus half. That is L minus L by 2. That is X1 equal to L by 2 minus TH by WL. Now we can find out for the sag S1 and then S2. That is the sag S1 equal to W into X1 square by 2T. Substitute X1 value here. That is W into L by 2 minus TH by WL whole square by 2T. What is S2? W into X2 square by 2T. What is the value of X2? L by 2 plus THW by WL. Substitute here. We are getting when the supports are at unequal level. And the next third one is effect of wind and ice on sag. Here, this is for the conductor. The top of the conductor, the formation of the ice particle. Generally, in the transmission line are laid in the hilly areas, cause transmission line conductor sometimes affected for the heavy wind pressure and the ice formation. Here, the two weight is there. One is for the actual weight of the conductor, that is represent for the W, and the ice weight is represent for WI, and WW is represent for the wind velocity weight. This is the conductor. The thickness of the conductor is represent for the T, and the diameter of the conductor is represent for D, and this is for the two weight. One is for the horizontal weight, that is represent for the wind weight. I can see this is for the conductor. The vertical downwards, that is for the actual weight of the conductor plus formation of the ice particle or the formation of the dust particle. And the horizontal, the affected, that is nothing but the wind velocity. The horizontal affected, that is for the wind velocity. Here the two forces is acting. One is for the vertical force, another one is for the horizontal force. The vertical force is the actual weight of the conductor. The conductors are classified for solid conductor, standard conductor, hollow conductor, and then bundle conductor. In solid conductor, the weight is more comparing to the standard conductor. And here the two weight is there. One is for the actual weight of the conductor is presented by vertical, and the formation of the dust particle or the ice weight, that is presented on the vertical, and the wind velocity, the wind pressure is presented on the horizontal. Here we want to find out the resultant weight, that is the total weight of the conductor, that is represent for WT. W is represent for the actual weight of the conductor, WI, effect of ice coating, WW, that is the wind velocity weight, and WT is represent for the resultant weight or total weight of the conductor per unit length. We can take according to Pythagoras theorem, that is the resultant weight WT equal to square root of W plus WA whole square plus WW whole square. W plus WA whole square plus WW whole square. The WW in the sense the wind weight is presented on the horizontal, W plus WI is presented on the vertical, actual weight of the conductor plus ice weight. That is W is represent for weight of conductor per unit length, and WI is represent for weight of ice per unit length, and WW in the sense wind force per unit length. Actually, this is affected only in the hilly areas, because in a year 365 days the climate is not same. The change of the climate condition, some of the times in the atmospheric air itself the moisture is available, that in that the open atmosphere all the conductor in the visible, it's observed for the dust particle. In the top of the dust particle the moisture is observed, due to that some amount of the weight is increased in the conductor. This is the effect of wind and ice on a sack. The next one, this disadvantages of loose pen. So actually at the time of erection, this is the two supporting structure is there. One is the supporting structure A, another one is the supporting structure B. You can take the supporting structure is pole or tower. At the time of erection, they are given for a small amount of dip or the small amount of sag to avoid the breakage of the conductor. That is, to mechanical stress, they are given a small amount of dip or the small amount of sag. And based upon the atmospheric condition or based upon the temperature, after 6 months or after 1 year, the sag occurred is more. The sag occurred is more. That is, the difference of the two supporting structure and the lowest point of the conductor is represented for sag. Now, suppose if the disadvantages of loose pen at the time of erection, the sag occurred is more. What are the drawbacks that appear? The first one, if the sag is more than the prescribed maximum limit, that is as per the standard limit, there is a possibility of conductor clashing during windy days. If the conductors are the sag occurred is more in between the conductors, if the little bit of the wind pressure is, the two conductors are clashed to each other due to the small wind pressure or in the windy days, which causes a short circuit. That is, if the two conductors are short to each other, that is the spark is appeared, the voltage drop, the current is increased. And one more thing, in the particular the place of the short circuit, the conductor is comes under rough surface. Once the conductor is comes under the rough surface, in effect is more, the corona occurrence is high, and the voltage drop is also increased. These are the major drawback in the conductors are loose pen. And the second one, if the sag is more, then the length of conductor material required is also more. Suppose here supporting structure A to supporting structure B, the total, for example, 150 meters, total 150 meters, the total span length, you can assuming 150 meters. Here we are given for the small amount of dip or sag. How much the conductor is required? That is 160 to 165 meter. Suppose if the sag is more, means in the particular place, the conductor material required is more. That is, in the particular place, the material requirement is 180 meter. Once the conductor material is increased, means the cost is increased, that the burden is presented to the consumer. That is one more drawback. And the another drawback is, due to the loose span, the conductor will vibrate irregularly. Suppose if the small amount of the wind pressure is there, if the small amount of the wind pressure is there, the sag occurred is more. If the little bit of the wind pressure is there, the conductor is vibrated. At that time, the current is coming from the non-sinusoidal current. Actually, this is the current is flowing from the non-sinusoidal. Due to the conductor vibration, the current is flowing from the non-sinusoidal. Due to that, the charging current is affected and the capacitor is also affected. And once the vibration is occurred, means the strain is presented on the supporting structure. That is, the strain is presented on the insulator. That is either pin type insulator, suspension, or strain type insulator. That is, conductors will vibrate irregularly and hence be subjected to strain at the point of the fixing. Once the sag occurred is more, the small amount of the wind pressure is there, the conductor will vibrate irregularly. Due to that, the current is flowing for non-sinusoidal. That effect is presented on the fixing of the conductor. That is affected for insulator, either pin type insulator, suspension, strain, or shackle type insulator. To avoid this, all the thing, we need to follow for the as per the standards. These are the drawbacks of the loose span of the conductor. The primary thing, once the conductors are laid in the loose span, if the sag is occurred more, that is the possibility of conductor clashing during the windy days. Once the conductors are clashed to each other, that is the short circuit is appeared in the particular point, voltage is dropped, current is more. In the particular place, the conductor is comes under the rough surface. Once the conductor is comes under the rough surface, the voltage drop is also increased. And the second one, the conductor material requirement is more. Now, this is the two supporting structure. One is represent for the supporting structure A. The second one is represent for the supporting structure B. Here, for example, the supporting structure A to the supporting structure B, the span length is 150 meter. Here, actual the conductor material requirement is 160 to 165 meter. If the span occurred is more, means here the material is required for 180 meters. Due to that, the overall cost is increased. And once the sag occurred is more, if the small amount of the wind pressure, the conductor will vibrate irregularly. Due to that, the current is concentrated for non-sinusoidal. Once the current is non-sinusoidal current, it's affected for the charging current, that is IC. That is IC equal to 2 pi FC into V phase. 2 pi FC into V phase. That is, the charging current is directly proportional to the capacitance. That is, the capacitor is affected. Already we know that from starting point to up to the ending point, that is generating station to the receiving substation or one substation to another substation, parameter it should be maintained for constant. That is, resistance, inductance, and other needs for the capacitance. These are the various drawbacks if the conductors are connected in the loose span.